Thank you. Welcome to the 2021 Convocation Ceremony of Bishop's University. Before we begin the celebration of our graduating students, all 812 of them, let's take a moment to honor our history. Bishop's University is located on the traditional and unceded territory of the Abenaki people. L'Université de Bishop's est située sur le territoire traditionnel et non cédé du peuple Abenaki. The phrase traditional and unceded territory is too often used as a pro forma statement of fact. Recent events have given that statement a new and poignant meaning now that hundreds of undocumented and unmarked graves have been found on the grounds of former residential schools. Like people, countries accumulate debts, and our historical debt to Indigenous Canadians came due a long time ago. Dialogue, the civility of conversation, is crucial to the resolution of any issue, but only if it is accompanied by action. To that point, we here at Bishop's have begun the process of learning from our dialogue with the Abenaki people. We are fortunate to have wise and engaged Indigenous leaders such as Chief Richard Obomsawin, Susie Obomsawin, and Dr. Abel Bosom joining us in this long overdue journey of reckoning and reconciliation through their efforts on the Bishops' Council and the Bishops' Board of Governors. The word convocation comes from the Latin convocare, to call together. Well, this is the 193rd time we've been called together as a university. It is the second time we've been called together for a virtual graduation ceremony. C'est remarquable que dans nos 193 années d'histoire, c'est seulement la deuxième fois que notre collation des grades ne se déroule pas en présentiel, malgré tous les efforts de notre communauté. And today's ceremony is only the first phase of your convocation, which will conclude next June with all of you back here on campus together. Before I formally open our convocation ceremony, I invite you to enjoy some of our community members with Teresa Graham of the class of 2021 as a soloist, perform Leonard Cohen's Hallelujah. Like this. Thank you, Teresa, and thank you to our community choir. Upon being named chancellor last year, I explained why that I felt the bishops is such a special place. But after the year that we have experienced together, I realize now just how special. There is just no way to sugarcoat this. Your graduating class is unique in our time in that during your final year here, you faced the full force of the COVID-19 pandemic head on. You confronted the challenging circumstances in which you found yourselves with resilience, determination, creativity, and innovation. And your compassion and empathy for your fellow students and professors highlighted the finest quality of the Bishop's community, selflessness. The solidarity displayed by all of you acting together with the ultra-engaged Bishop's faculty and administration has resulted in a year of impressive achievements, as Principal Goldblum will explain in a few minutes. Physically on campus, it may have appeared that Bishop's came to a full stop during the pandemic, but in reality, the Bishop's community kept making giant strides forward. It is the strength of character you demonstrated each and every day in so many different ways, both large and small, that I believe will play a significant part in your shaping your future. So I congratulate you, the distinguished class of 2021, for having overcome those challenging and daunting circumstances and for having come out the other side successful and, I'm convinced, stronger for the experience. Je vous félicite d'avoir surmonté ces circonstances difficiles et des fois décourageantes et d'être sorti de l'autre côté avec succès et, j'en suis convaincu, plus fort de cette expérience. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank everyone who supported you in your studies here at Bishop's, in particular your parents, who I know from experience are today as happy, as proud, and yes, as relieved as you are. But every graduating class and every generation from time immemorial has had to face its own unique set of challenging circumstances, some admittedly more perilous and more fraught with difficulty and danger than others. But it is how we as individuals deal with those challenges and those dangers that will in the final analysis determine who we are as individuals and ultimately what we are as a society. Whether it be our treatment of Indigenous Canadians, climate change, systemic racism, or economic disparity, there is no shortage of issues that require our attention and that will require much more of yours in the future. I believe that the liberal education you have received here at Bishop's in your time will allow you to recognize all of these vital issues for what they really are. Immense challenges, yes, but equally wonderful opportunities to participate to whatever degree you can in the effort to tackle and solve those problems. And in so doing, improve your life, the life of your community, your province, your country, and your world. Je crois que vos années à Bishop's vous positionnent parfaitement pour passer à un niveau d'implication important. Vous serez plus que capable de réussir. I'm not advocating here for grand gestures, for oftentimes it is the small things we do which accomplish the most. In 1966, Senator Robert Kennedy addressed students at the University of Cape Town in South Africa during the struggle against apartheid. That day, so many years ago now, he encouraged the students to do what they could to improve the lot of their fellow citizens and for the dignity of humanity, and said, "Each time a person stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope. And crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring, those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance." Well, 30 years later, apartheid was consigned to the ash can of history. So now it is time for each of you, the members of the distinguished class of 2021, to send forth your own tiny ripple of hope, which when joined together with others, will swell into a mighty current and contribute positively to the future of your communities. and I have every confidence you will. You will forever be part of the Bishop's family. You have made friendships that will last a lifetime. You are extremely well equipped to meet the moment. Enjoy yourselves on this truly important day. Congratulations, félicitations. As you all know, one of the great gifts that bishops gives us is the opportunity to get to know some truly remarkable people. For me, one of the exceptional people I have met is the chair of the Bishops' Council, Yolande James. Like me, Yolande had to overcome the distinct disadvantage of not having studied at Bishops. She has done pretty well all the same. She's a lawyer. She was the first Black female member of Quebec's National Assembly. And when she was appointed Minister of Immigration and Cultural Communities, she was Quebec's first Black cabinet minister. As chair of the Bishops' Council, Yolande has helped the university address important issues of how to advance equity, diversity, and inclusion. And as director of the Bishops' Forum, she has helped develop a new generation of leaders for Quebec's English-speaking community. It is truly my pleasure to invite Yolande James to address the class of 2021.
Chancellor Fournier, thank you so much for that lovely introduction. The university has been fortunate to benefit from your leadership as we move through these challenging times. Chair Bob Hall, Principal Goldblum, faculty members, staff, family and friends, dear graduates, good afternoon. As chair of the Bishop's Council, it is a great honor for me to share in this very special time in your lives. Granted, convocation has always been an important moment in the lives of bishops, graduates, friends, family, faculty, as well as the larger Bishops University community. But this convocation is unlike others. In this time, you're embarking on the next stage of your life just as the world is recovering from an event that's impacted our very relationships with each other. This next stage of your life begins as the world opens up again and discovers what it means to live in a new, well, hopefully post-COVID reality. Opening doors, engaging anew, new beginnings offer the chance to rise to the many challenges and meet every opportunity to be and do better. As you begin this new chapter and boldly walk your path, may the lessons you learned, your liberal arts education, guide you. Over the years, there have been many who have championed the value of a liberal arts education. I want for you to leave here with the knowledge that your liberal arts education is the best preparation for the challenges we are facing today. How will we implement meaningful justice for Indigenous communities? How can we ensure that our answers to climate change are solutions that are accessible and inclusive? How do we equitably sustain democracies in a sea of disinformation? In your time here at Bishops, you were honing the tools you need to analyze, to critique, and to develop your own thoughts and ideas and opinions about the world. Your generation is among the first to have rapid and unfettered access to all humankind's knowledge. Your liberal arts education equips you to not only participate in any debate, but to lead it. As you lead, remember to tell the truth, as Maya Angelou said. She said, "Tell the truth to yourself first and to the children. Live in the present. Don't deny the past, and know that the charge is on you to make the country better than it is today." Your generation continues to teach us what it means to bring your whole self to every debate and conversation. So keep speaking up, keep standing up, and keep speaking truth to power. Know that how you defend these convictions is just as important as your faith in them. Votre génération continue à nous enseigner ce que cela signifie d'apporter tout son être à chaque débat et conversation. Alors, continuez à vous exprimer, à vous tenir debout et à dire la vérité au pouvoir. Sachez que que la façon dont vous êtes, dont vous défendez ces convictions, est tout aussi important que votre foi en elles. Truth be told, compromise and consensus building do not get the spotlight, accolades, and shine they deserve. But compromise and consensus building are superpowers. Without them, there is no progress. More and more research on successful leadership is telling us that impactful transformational leadership is rooted in vulnerability, on other-centeredness. I'll submit to you that if there is no progress without consensus, there is no consensus without the courage of vulnerability. And let's be clear, we're not talking about compromising your purpose. That is unassailable. We're talking about the work that progress requires of you. To look at the life of a Nelson Mandela is to know that oppressive systems like apartheid are not dismantled without consensus. Consensus that is informed by purpose, by justice. It's courageous and effective. So be not afraid to listen and engage with those who do not see the world as you do. Chers diplômés, toutes mes félicitations. Aujourd'hui, vous avez toutes les raisons d'être fiers. Prenez le temps de savourer le moment et de profiter pleinement de vos accomplissements. Once again, my heartfelt congratulations. This is your time. Lead the way.
We will now proceed with the conferring of degrees. Each student will be introduced by their respective dean.
Mr. Chancellor and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Bachelor of Arts.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Lily Madeleine Rousseau. Sabrina Perrault, with distinction. Émilie Binet-Patoine, with distinction. Marianne Jutras-Bouvette. Adam Laberry, with distinction. Stephen Lavac, with distinction. Haley McEwen, with distinction. Marie-Ève Melly, with distinction. Francis Cameron, with distinction. Claire Bohm, with distinction. Casey Hébert, with distinction. Africa Hurtado Vasquez. Lara Dion. Francine Etier, with distinction. Cameron Kirky. Émilie Labbé. Brooklyn Trudy Catherine Lahaye. Jordan Snade Dewar. Nicholas Paul Kaiser Reese, with distinction. Spencer Kolarczyk Christensen, with distinction. Carly Megan Tuck. Maria Clavelli Granja, with distinction. Golden Mitre Award. Claudia Lafleur, with distinction. Océane Francoeur Pereira, with distinction. Holly Benison, with distinction. Samuel Emerson McCullough Utroza. Steve Breton, with distinction. Jeanne Hébert Desjardins. Katerina Janevski. Corinne Roch. Aiden Brassard. David Buhusu. Philippe Lapointe Lassonde. Rafaela da Silva Domingue. Émilie Gagné. Shane McDonald Bryan. Anne Butler. Chanel Coates. Frédéric Lestage. Hayden Briggs. Matthias Aubert. Jennifer Allen, with distinction. Benjamin Deceve-Simard. Patricia Gamache, with distinction. Liam Arp. Emilio Puerta, with distinction. Lise Belmar. Cedric William Werner Moore. Vanessa Williams. Megan Galatly. Fanny Gagnon. Sarah Lavoie.
Ophelia Welsh. Amelia Abran. Yuchi Liu. Anchala Sathananthan, with distinction. Sandrine Crespe Lacroix, with distinction. Gabriel S. Childs. Rose Seitz. Catherine Sharp. Jiang Yuan Tsi. Paul Lu Pepin. Sifan Sa. Eva Perrault Gagnon, with distinction. John Quayle. William Vincent Babineau. Eileen Irina Rebecca Lachkar. Thomas Dawson, with distinction. Leah Driver. Yen Yen. John Robert Dunn. Corinthon Messina, with distinction. Adriana Nicole Torres Rivas. Zoe Gilio, with distinction. Shane Redmond, with distinction.
Jessica Hawkins. Simon Martin Trudeau. Shannon Lowe. Olivier Judy. Locke Alexander Storm Bailey, with distinction. Lauren McCullough. Marianne Champagne, with distinction. Sally Jane Louise Cunningham, with distinction. Teresa Graham, with distinction. Camille Ferlot, with distinction. Jessica Laurie. Kevin Neal. Alexandre Tremblay, with distinction.
Bridie McDonough.
Mr. Chancellor and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Bachelor of Science.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Science in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Emilien Cloutier, with distinction. Anthony Sonogo, with distinction. Wei Wu.
Dominique Bourget, with distinction. Grace Ann Belzil, with distinction. Kobe Welch, with distinction. Guillaume Denoncourt, with distinction. Samuel Haskett Fisher, with distinction. Joshua Aiken. Fatima Zahra Ouslimi, with distinction. Laurence Isabelle Boyer-Apollon. Frédéric Caillé. Jian Li. Jack Campos. Adrian Zimmer. Patricia Aubin, with distinction. Rachel Hellerud. Ha Huak Hung Ngo, with distinction. Alexa Riley. Sarah Elliott, with distinction. Devlin Kofelt. Rabia Elkisto. Jean-Christophe Belil, with distinction. Xuan He, with distinction. Xingyu Wen, Teng Yan, Yang Zheng, Runchen Zhao, Sinyu Zhao, with distinction. Governor General's Silver Medal, Myriam Gervais, with distinction. Monica Palsou, Georges-Philippe Gadoury sans façon, with distinction. Yuqing Ma, Hilary Bryson, with distinction. Kareem Fathi, with distinction. Crystal Laws, Maria Zinchenko, Emma Blackburn, with distinction. Gabrielle Valentin Morariou, Camille Catalan, with distinction. Briac Baker, with distinction. Nicola Beth Kish, with distinction. Rachel Berube, Thirani Balakrishnan, Brianna Elizabeth Corey, with distinction. Eva Kuhar, Alexandra Lair, with distinction. Noah Locke, Sasha Maria Maroon, with distinction. Melissa Rivera Byres, Emma Story, Ariane Charette, with distinction. Madeline Skinner, Yanchun Chi, with distinction. Hortense Barbier Saint-Hilaire, Serena Fiorillo, William Poole, Kate Schwartz,
Alex Dennison,
Julien Kredelka, Abigail Barnes, Francesca Wagner, Odette Charlene Chuan, Hassan Al-Saidi, Danielle Arma, Yi Hong, with distinction. Yanming Liu, with distinction. Ashana Hines, with distinction.
Mr. Chancellor and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Bachelor of Arts.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Xiyi Shi, Corinne Dory, with distinction. Delphine Paquette, Isabelle Anne Ricard, with distinction. Hannah Hornibrook, with distinction. Maya Lugar, with distinction. Stacy Forward, with distinction. Zachary Fry, Danica Lambert, with distinction. Victoria Smodis McCune, with distinction. Pierre Olivier Paradis, with distinction. Jason Roberge, with distinction. Pascal Rousseau, with distinction. Benjamin Turgeon, with distinction. Noémie Vien, with distinction. Rachel Rothmal Prize. Trinity Mastin, with distinction. Sarah Gilbert. Brianna Patrick, with distinction. Rachelle Lee Perra, with distinction. Melanie Pigeot Nardoza, with distinction. Claire Keddy, with distinction. Melina Poulin, with distinction. John James Blanchette. Vivienne Maffey, with distinction. Vivianne Court Rathwell, with distinction. Marie-Pierre Allard Caron, Maximin Fehe, Andy Marie Jacobs, with distinction, Marianne Berger, with distinction, Gabrielle Boudreau, with distinction, Dalton English, Andrew Jeremy Harrison, Matty Ruth Haynes, Nicolas Jobin, Adam Salins, Gabrielle Savard Bergeron, with distinction, Caitlin Checky, Liam Pierre Mathieu Tissot, with distinction, Reese Tomko, Matthew Wolf, Jesse Berube, Hugo Givens, Léa Lavigne, Rosalie Provencher, Valerie Reed, Bryce Salverda, Marshall Billingsley LeBlanc, Justin Jarmok, Rebecca Maduro, with distinction, Luca Como, Frédéric Desnoyers, William Miller, Ryan Simmons, Sophie Chagnon, Neil Driscoll, Liam Douglas Brian Elliott, Shelby Page, with distinction, Ferdinand Kaus, Armin Pagosian, Omar Al-Zahrani, Mirza Saad Beg, Mathieu Guimet, Paul Antoine Lepage, Sriram Raman, Dylan Ball, Megan Corrigan, Astrid Delpol, with distinction, Aaron Ranu Franklin, Sophie Goyette, with distinction, Jean-Guy Cronstall, Gabrielle Labbé, with distinction, Nanthicha Leniel,
Catherine Martel, Elizabeth McBain, with distinction, Stacy Poulain, Alexia Magda Qureshi, with distinction, Kelsey Michaela Robson, with distinction, Maria Salvatore, Angela Maria Useche Perez, Annabelle Veilleux, with distinction, Finley Berry, Wilton Burgos, Gabrielle Chamberlain, Sarah Connor, Kenya Hamel Ramanjulu, Lori Lacombe, Jessica Langlois, with distinction, Lucia Amanda Santilli, Ryan May Seiler, Samantha White Couture, Ramin Akbari, Sandrine Bouchard, Shauna Chatterton Jerome, Philippe Depart, Keegan McKay, Natalie Nickel, Carl William Sevigny, Jacob Carrier, Callie Parrish, Eric Charles Gendron, with distinction, Erica Morrow, with distinction, Mathieu Arsenault, Elena Bialdi, Jordan Thornhill, Brianna DeCoste, Hannah Wallace, with distinction, Connor Blanchet, Amanda Colleen, Christian Kobzar, Bailey Rhodes, Graham Poole, Keisha Brew, with distinction, Colette Emma Chaltier, Amanda Lloyd, Jenna Ann Wires, Jatin Jose, Thomas Yopis, Sean Granath, Stefan Longlois, Claire Piana, Annie Tessier, with distinction, Alec Lamoureux, Simon Meloche, Peyton Wagner, Timothy Patrick G. Nolan, Michael Harris, Leanne Abbott, Julien Quentin Chrysler Martin, Stephanie Edwards, Malcolm Fava, with distinction, Claudia Fairland, with distinction, Rebecca Struss, Ryan Smith, Jasmine Levasseur, with distinction, Doris Verice Nussi Dave, Natasha Roy, Charlotte Tim, Taha Al Hout, Khalida Fakiri, J. Haddad Sharma, Nicole Joni Platerotti, Micheline Gabelus, Guillaume Trottier, Maxime Huard, Matteo Nobile, Katia Perrin, with distinction, Thomas James Saunders, Gabriel Bally Wapachi, Sally Ibrahim, Shue U Wanchu, Luansu Jong, Vernon Campbell, Samuel Duchamp, Tomas Janelza, Kother Sedum, François Nicolas Prunet Doré, Bryson Lalune, Eric Whistle, Sarah Verano, Marc Desjardins, Nassim Osama D. El Shorji, Marie Evradine Berouette, Sabrina Lavallée, Patrick Tsitsikas, Thomas Brien Brodard, Ruli Loa, with distinction, Siulok Tang, with distinction, Lucia Pia Dardon Rojas, Sabrina Chouinard, Calvin Defayette, Megan Pomainville, Irina Kane, Joshua Brennan Hoekstra, Emma Ferguson, Amadou Diallo,
Stephanie Paquette Morales, Almoatassim Agahami,
Shakiba Rahim Mayanyo, Courtney Alexandra Loomis.
Eric Verville. Nathan James McGeechee. Chloe Anestis. Vincent Scully.
Rachel Amalia Morgan.
Amelia Kralis, with distinction.
Brooklyn Christina Sawatsky. Zachary Sear, with distinction. Yannick Blouin.
Emmanuel Elie. Catherine Dion, with distinction.
Sean Turk.
James Young. Fiona Amara, with distinction.
Chloe Massé-Grégoire. Ryan Mulhern. Ulrich Ladussard, with distinction.
Kimberly Megan Bell. Melissa Chiarella. Catherine Johanna Blay, with distinction. Raphael Chabot Essayag, with distinction.
Corey Williams. Isabel Jane Vaux, with distinction. Gemma Camara. Sarah Caimano, with distinction. The Vice Chancellor's Prize. Anya Monroe, with distinction. Isabelle Françoise Audet, with distinction. The Julie Bradshaw Memorial Award. Quincy Carby Riddell. Kimberly Gagnon. Mohamed Adnane Eder, with distinction. Duncan Alderdice. Megan Cooper, with distinction. Elizabeth D'Souza. Jill Morrison. Raphael Gauthier Bisaillon, with distinction.
I now invite one of this year's valedictorians, Sally Cunningham, to address the convocation.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Every late night study session that turned into morning, every sprint to the printer before class, every job worked and every drop of caffeine consumed, every tear shed and every grade earned has culminated in this moment. Breathe it in, it has all been worth it. We chose Bishops for a host of reasons: to keep up our French, to have an individualized academic experience, to be in a rural area, to uphold family traditions, or to branch out and create new ones. And we've arrived where we are today because of the guidance of so many. I would like to take a moment to thank every parent and guardian for your support and love. For many of us, you are the reason we have the strength to be here today. I would like to thank the faculty for their patience, enthusiasm, and unwavering belief in our class. Your commitment to higher education is indispensable. Thank you to every staff member who works to accommodate the smooth running of this university. The extra tissues, the directions in McGreer, and the endless help untangling course requirements does not go unnoticed. Thank you to the locals and businesses of Lenoxville for tolerance as we descended upon the town each year. And a special mention goes out to the Domino's delivery drivers who provide an invaluable service. Thank you, everyone, for all that you do, all that you have done, so that we may graduate. You are recognized in our accomplishments today. J'aimerais prendre un moment pour reconnaître notre histoire et notre contexte francophone. Tout ce que nous avons accompli a été grâce à la nature accueillante de la communauté qui nous entoure. Nous sommes tellement chanceux d'avoir eu l'opportunité d'apprendre non seulement en classe et sur le campus, mais aussi à Sherbrooke en nous immergeant dans la langue française. Notre expérience est rendue plus riche par notre association et notre alliance avec la communauté francophone. Je sais que je serai toujours reconnaissante d'avoir appris à commander un café
appris à naviguer les différents choix de produits dans une épicerie et même appris à négocier une coupe de cheveux dans une deuxième langue. Je félicite également tous ceux et celles qui ont obtenu leur diplôme dans leur langue seconde. Vous êtes peut-être les plus courageux et courageuses d'entre nous. When I read this following poem, it reminds me of walking down Rue Connolly in early December on my way to class. The power lines lean overhead, the red bricks are bright against the winter sky, the footpath through Little Forks has been tramped down by someone with an earlier class, and it's the kind of cold that makes your lungs hurt. Here's Perfect Song by Heather Christie. I remember walking through the morning after a night of heavy snow and drink, with headphones on, and they played me the most perfect song. No one was awake, and I was hungover, young, as clean as a piano. I thought, and at any moment, someone might fall in love with me. I was that woven into the electric, cold, bright air. And for weeks after, I went through the album in search of the song, but could not find it. And later, much later, I saw that what I had taken to be the song was in fact the joyous concordance of a moment that would not come again. As graduating students, we know that Bishop's is full of that joyous concordance. We came to Lenoxville fresh-faced and unsure. We sat in Centennial listening to Principal Goldblum ask us where we all came from. We're still from all those places: Montreal, Vancouver, Boston, Punta del Este, Abu Dhabi, everywhere, even the famous Denver, Colorado, Central America. And now, we are also from Lenoxville, this beautiful place on the traditional territory of the Abenaki people and the Wabanaki Confederacy, tucked into the fold between the Massawippi Shore and the St. Francis River. We know that the Bishop's experience is a collection of things. The late night pasta station at Dewey's, studying in the library, getting distracted in the library, coat check at the gate, the music that plays before exams in the gym, Donald lectures and department parties. Bishop's is the walk home from the lion, the walk to the gym. It's floats and the never-ending parade of costumes. Bishop's is Winterfest and Eco Week, research labs and a miniature horse for Mental Health Week. It's knowing what all your neighbors' living rooms look like, conversations with professors that happen anywhere and often with a beer. It is the parade of waves exchanged under the arches. The Bishop's experience is a collective one. Sadly, we have failed the school song. We were once conditioned to our fate, and now we will graduate. Although the raucous, rigorous, rhapsodic experience of being an undergraduate may be over, the future lies ahead. The trick is that we have to convince ourselves that we can have this particular feeling again and better. Bishop's was where we learned how to learn, how to ask the right questions. We learned how to do laundry, how to go a year without vegetables, how to celebrate a birthday away from home. We learned and we grew up. And in growing up, we cultivated our voices, voices that are defined by hope. Our class has survived the pandemic, several floods, too many fires, endless construction, and the closure of the gate. Through all of this, we leaned on each other until we found the strength in ourselves. While this particular Bishop's moment may never come again, our hope, our empathy, and our resilience will carry through into everything we do, because now we are Bishop's. Whether your purple spirit manifests as a call to excellence or to quiet contemplation, or a network of lifelong friends, a part of Bishop's belongs to you now. You are marked by it. May we as a class commemorate that the serendipity of our time at Bishop's has ended, and may we as individuals celebrate as we strike out into the world beyond our bubble. As we stand here today, victorious, let us look back with fondness for this joyous moment, and let us rush into the glorious future. It is time. We have redefined what it is to be a student at Bishop's, and now we will redefine what it means to be a Bishop's graduate. Congratulations, class of 2021. We did it.
We will now continue with the conferring of degrees. Once again, each student will be introduced by their respective dean.
Mr. Chancellor and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Bachelor of Arts.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Jackson Vickerstaff.
Justin Couchet. Marilyn Hardy. Abigail McLean, with distinction. Anna Veilleux-Malone, with distinction. Golden Mitre Award. Nathan Allard. Emile Gelina. Jack Gorky. Ewan Lawton. Shane Walter McDonald, with distinction. Chief Justice Greenshields Prize. Domenico Mano. Lori Kim Girard. Hugh Godman, with distinction. Noah Rose.
Kevin Moreau, with distinction. Chloe Comtois.
Annabelle Côté-Laurie.
Mr. Chancellor and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Business in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Camille Bédard. Samia Kuna, with distinction. Amber Cook. Yaoxian Dai, with distinction. Fiona Ann Doran, with distinction. Amir Khan Hamdard. Melina Kralis, with distinction. Victoria McIntosh. Louvre Mestone Musinget. Rodrigo Alonso Piscoya Saavedra. McLean Allen Robert Poulin. Jiaoji Run. Weston Ryan. Jamie Juliette Vanegas Aguirre. Rachel Wilson. Jiaqian Yuan. Daniel Harrington. Norman McNiven. Aiden Joseph Maloney. Noémie Soleil Cormier. Chad Bisaillon Lemelin, with distinction. Alexandre Bourque-Labbé, with distinction. Bastien Bourque-Labbé, with distinction. Bernard Duchesne, with distinction. Karian Emmanuel Kwaku. Sarah Madison Kirby Mosjej. Maude Richard, with distinction. Philippe Monrioux. Charles Saint-Arnaud, with distinction. Anne Constance Blanchette, with distinction. Sammy Eve Coutu. Hilary Doyle. Sophie Maude Madeiros Dubé. Sean Giddings. Beatrice Landry, with distinction. Vanessa Kaylin Leonard. Dawson Lyon. Samuel McDonald. Skylar Marshall, with distinction. Quincy Faye McKenna. Daniel Kenneth Norman Noel, with distinction. Berke
Uzkumova. Quentin Vandeville. Clara Cardwan, with distinction. Nicholas Greenshields. Isabelle Lefebvre, with distinction. Anthony Andrew Palumbo. Samuel Bégin. Charles-Étienne Béliveau-Péré, with distinction. Gabriel Brissette-Forte. William Dale. Ivy Juliana Denham. Justine Durocher. Louis-Dimitri Goupil. Sabrina Bintacone. Jordan Leggetti, with distinction. Sandrine Leroux-Boucher, with distinction. Juliette Lessard-Tétrault. Louis-Charles Maheu, with distinction. Jenna Elizabeth Reichard. Antoine Rivard. Anastasia Saïd Alaoui, with distinction. Adam Smith. Kennedy Thompson, with distinction. Alistair Arnott Tomaszewski, with distinction. Morgan Whitaker. Jean-François Cardinal, with distinction. Alexandre Lecourt. Peter Demakos, with distinction. Rodney Ethan Malcolm. Mara Wynn. Jessica Doddage, with distinction. Alyssa Fee, with distinction. Joanie Castor Tadal. Sami Kove, with distinction. Adam Grant. Mark Zachary Lambert Seward, with distinction. William Simard. Emily Squires. Elisabelle Cossette Plamondon, with distinction. Rosalie Thérien. Riley Thompson. Shai Bouskila. Dave Lag-Lauzon, with distinction. Jake Waplack.
Jennifer Gagnon. Judith Payet. Shuiyun Shen, with distinction. Catherine Nicole Vela Colina. Tristan Girard. Jacob Lay. Jordan Simard.
Alicia Boutin.
Cathy Demaresque-Robert. Salma Flores Desrochers. Yaya Medboul. Joanie Paulson-Tillus. Marceau Bertin. Marc-Antoine Fougue. Christopher Potter. Austin Thériault. Kyuzi Yang. Marjorie Duarte Rosales. Benjamin McDonald. Charlotte Mayo. Tatiana Ortiz Cornejo.
David Rumbach.
Shauna Christine Guile.
Andrew Nielsen, with distinction.
Brendan Jeffrey Wiley, with distinction.
Thomas Bakief. Brian Chilvers. William Subrani. Caroline McKechin. Emile Babin, with distinction.
Khadija Mabdoul.
Mr. Chancellor and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Bachelor of Arts.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Arts in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Courtney Waugh. Delaney Benson. Mary Lou Waver. Tamika Briggs. Abby Cameron, with distinction. Allison Comtois. Sarah Cote. Miranda Cote. Marie-Ève Couture-Boisvert. Rachel Elizabeth Gauvreau. Caitlin Gibson. Danielle Huntley. Lauren Hutchings. Cassandra Johnson Denoyer. Sarah Kane. Selena Jean Lorin. Saffron Leahy Levesque. Sandy McDonald. Lindsay Moore. Caitlin Osborne. Hélène Wimette Fieldsend. Kendra Parnell. Andreanne Richard. Hayden Richmond. Chelsea Gale Swan. Samantha Ruth Tricky, with distinction. Madison Van Bierschoten, with distinction. Audrey Wojciech. Stephanie Armstrong. Augusta Cowell. Kevin Doré. Sarah Jane Girl. Samuel Marchand. Iunhia Rorox McComer. Miranda Martine Serrano, with distinction. Victoria Starnino, with distinction. Anique Whitty, with distinction. Allison Faber. Isaac Matthews Hanna. Erica Champigny Rolfe. Roy Henderson. Olivia Hewitt. Samuel LaGuire O'Connell. Chelsea Moran. Taylor Rohr. Anna Hughes. Jordan Charpentier. Jaleesa Chanel. Rebecca Forger-Lariviere. Gabrielle Gendron. Catherine Hanfield, with distinction. Danica Lebrecht, with distinction. Samuel LaFontaine. Jacob LaPlante. Nicolas Lebeau. Yifeng Li. Corinne St. Laurent Amel. Owen Teolis. Samantha Bliss. Kaylee Grobecker. Nicholas Gibbs, with distinction. Isabel Boucher. Bernadette Grace Labbé. Shayna Lavoie. Emily Blair Boone, with distinction. Alex Marcel. Christian Munafo, with distinction. Samantha DeVries, Strathcona Foundation plaque. Michaela Elliott. Victoria St. Germain. Kate Kinsman. Gianni Morone. Marta Ismain Dupont, with distinction. Muna Abdallah, with distinction. Kaylee McDonald. Stephen Campo, with distinction. Holden Gold, with distinction. Emma Gunter. Taylor Sheldrick, with distinction. Bethany Teresa Hill. Giselle Murphy, with distinction. Madeleine Tom. Courtney McCrae, with distinction. Amanda Suro. Mark Morimoto. Sarah Wendell. Evan Lewis. Marie-Laurence Toussaint, with distinction. Alistair James Aiken, with distinction. Rose Gauthier. Granton Patrick, with distinction. Kate Sampson Elliott, with distinction. Alicia Ann Winter, with distinction.
Mr. Chancellor and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Bachelor of Education.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Bachelor of Education at our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Liam Meller. Lydia Toussaint. Delaney Benson. Samantha Bliss. Mary Lou Boisvert. Allison Comtois. Sarah Cote. Miranda Cote. Marie-Ève Couture-Boisvert. Samantha DeVries. Michaela Elliott. Jessica Marissa Freed. Rachel Elizabeth Govro. Caitlin Gibson. Emma Gunter. Anna Hughes. Danielle Huntley. Lauren Hutchings. Cassandra Johnson Denoyer. Sarah Kane. Taylor Lafave. Selena Jean Lorin. Shayna Lavoie. Saffron Leahy Levesque. Kaylee McDonald. Alex Marcel. Sandy McDonald. Caitlin Osborne. Hélène Ouimet-Fieldsend. Kendra Parnell. Andreanne Richard. Hayden Richmond. Victoria St. Germain. Chelsea Gail Swan. Amanda Suro. Madeleine Tom. Audrey Wojciech. Stephanie Armstrong. Erica Champigny-Rolfe. Jordan Charpentier. Jaleesa Chanel. Alyssa Dalmen. Kevin Dore. Allison Faber. Aislinn Fisher. Rebecca Forger-Lariviere. Gabrielle Gendron. Sarah Jane Girl. Olivia Hewitt. Bethany Teresa Hill. Adam Labery. Samuel LaFontaine. Jacob LaPlante. Nicolas LeBeau. Guillaume Leclerc Marceau. Samuel Marchand. Isaac Matthews Hanna. Eunhia Rorox McComber. Liam Meller. Chelsea Morin. Taylor Rohr. Courtney Waugh. Corinne St. Laurent Amel. Owen Teolis. Lydia Toussaint.
Elizabeth Legut.
Mackenzie Ryan Russell, with distinction. Rose Gauthier. Marie-Laurence Toussaint. Granton Patrick.
Mr. Chancellor, and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Master of Education.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Master of Education in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Quincy John Fernandez.
Lei Huang.
Ebenezer Oko Monkar. Darren Wilson.
Xiao Chi Chen. Bo Yun Li. Xiao Yan Liu. Yong Liu. Yu Qian Long. Xiao Yan Pon. Yi Xin Chen. Chu Qian Tan. Chia Ting Du. Chun Jia Wang. Zhu Fu Yong. Yan Ming Chang. Yu Tong Chou.
Laura Kirby. David Piperno. D.A. Catherine Corriveau. Yancy Shun.
Shuru Wang. Yating Wu. Huanhuan Do.
Mr. Chancellor, and all members of the university, with the unanimous approval of the convocation, I present to you these candidates in order that they may be granted the degree of Master of Science.
By the power vested in me, I admit you to the degree of Master of Science in our university, together with its responsibilities, rights, and privileges.
Han Bo. Swapandeep Swapandeep. Xinyu Wan.
Zhao Jiang. Ein Duk Lei. Siwan Liu. Wasif Jami Khan. Kartik Babu Vupendram. Luyun Ne.
Hamun Falak Farsa.
Jinsa Lin. Yi Ren. Akil Ahmed Mohammed.
Afreen Fatima Ahmed.
Lingarao Yachuri.
Farnaz Uruji. Ralph Roy Joseph.
Mojibola Oluwagbamiro Obadi Miji.
Mehdi Zuhinia.
Wentao Lu.
Sarah Eskan Dar Irad.
Daksh Madirata.
Rishab Bahal.
Ajay Kumari Shetty. Siva Sai Dinesh Mova.
Javad Omidvar. Rakesh Chandra Isle. Srikant Damodara Venkata Mohana. Nandini Dumpa. Abhilash Ediga. Sahitya Jad. Praniti Gokru. Sandeep Inala. Rajiv Dinesh Ishrani. Aditya Amitbhai Jani. Srivasta Abhishek Kasala. Mahak Lala. Ashwal Oza. Yash Patel. Jagannada Anjani Kumar Perry. Deepak Reddy Puramandla. Kameswaran Rangasamy. Bhuvanishwaran Ravi. Murali Akhil Rishirla. Naveen Samal. Kanan Srinivasan. Tatvagna Shah. Jasminder Singh. Manmeet Singh. Jayashri Shrini Vasan. Serlin Tamil Selvam. Apurva Pradeep Taikal. Swathi Van Kayala. Sai Chandrashika Reddy Vena. Navneet Verma. Shen Xiao Yen. Derek Alexandre Lizot.
Yan Chong. Raoul Aranki. Keshav Chai Vikosh Bolom. Hong Chong. Shartak Chabra. Manohar Joshi Dagolu. Kranti Dashari. Kirti Deva. Janil Deshay. Gaurav Dheer. Wancha Duan. Leonggu. Jiao Wei Guao. Ahmed Rateb Hamdan. Shu Gu Han. Yu Quan Hao. Surya Teja Charapati. Akin Taratil Jose. Nilufar Karimifar. Vishudi Redi Komuri. Onurag Korupati. Chiao Rei Li. Zhe Qian Li. Bing Xuan Liu. Yichang Liu. Choba Malela. Ruwen Mao. Yijun Mao. Chandona Marta. Bopalsan Sunil Kamar Musal. Oishurya Shriniva Naiki. Edmund Hendrik Jacob Gantong. Ali Norzad. Suyu Oyong. Wen Chin Pan. Dayuk Park. Shai Shiva Krishna Raul Ragada. Aravind Ragonda. Chiaofei Ren. Kartik Sakoja. Lokendar Sharna. Dhruv Sharma. Chichwan Shu. Povon Shishta. Malik Mujaffar Saeed. Bill Morrison Talat Jr. Pei Tian. Menidip Tolupunuri. Venkatesh Vajja. Akshay Vangapali. Prem Kumar Vaishnava. Pei Yan Wong. Shu Ting Wong. Sing Yong Wong, Governor General's Gold Medal. Chao Yi Wong. Chao Ching Wu. Su Mien Chu. Margav Chand Yadavali. Likita Yalavarti. Li Ming Yong. Hao Chen Shang. Yu Men Chang. Tian Yu Zhou.
Emily Prangley Desormo. Jessica Valerie Stacy. Gregory Gooding. Stephanie Cunningham Ryman. Patricia Oban. Alexandre Poulam. Hadley Leighton Pierce. Duncan Arthur Carson Crabtree. Kristen Alexandra Maria Dempsey. Thomas Dufresne. Andrew Jeremy Harrison. Chelsea Labrie. Simon Kevin Lizot. Gabrielle Pizichemi. Cheryl O'Neill.
Ming Zhong Yuan.
Ronald Pepin.
I now invite one of this year's valedictorians, Sabrina Binta Kone, to address the convocation.
When I initially found out I was in the running to be valedictorian, the very first thing I did was go online and look up as many speeches as possible for a little inspiration. I watched Oprah's speech to Harvard, Matthew McConaughey's speech to the University of Houston, and even some 12th grader's speech to his high school class, which wasn't too bad. But as I watched them all, I quickly realized that no one's speech would help me put into words what bishops means to all of us, because quite frankly, how could you know unless you've been through it yourself? So before I kick things off, I first want to say I'm absolutely honored to have been selected to commemorate such a defining milestone in our lives, and I want to give a big congratulations to the class of 2021. Nous devrions être extrêmement fiers d'avoir obtenu notre diplôme durant des circonstances aussi extrêmes. Nous avons passé une année à suivre des cours en ligne, à manquer nos événements préférés et à ne pas voir notre famille et nos amis aussi souvent. C'était une année assez difficile, mais nous l'avons quand même complétée la tête haute. That being said, as I look around this virtual crowd, our 2021 class truly is a powerhouse of brilliant minds who will change the world in impactful ways. Je veux aussi dire un grand merci aux professeurs, aux entraîneurs et aux tuteurs pour avoir joué un rôle si important durant nos parcours. À tous ceux grands et petits qui nous ont aidés en arrivant là, nous vous remercions tous. And finally, our parents. Our poor, poor parents who shipped us off to a school in the middle of nowhere and had to let their babies go. After today, you will officially be parents of university graduates. And if that doesn't make you feel old, I don't know what will. Now, as we all know, this place is one of a kind. To be quite honest, we probably sound a little crazy when we talk about it. Our school looks like Hogwarts, our campus is 2 minutes away from a place called Animal House, we regularly see each other walking around in fur coats during campus events, and I can't forget to mention that every year we serenade the principal at his house. All that to say, what we have here is quite unique, and you can't tell me the kids at Concordia are getting all of this experience. However, if you look beyond that, we have this sense of community that is like no other. Here at Bishops, we genuinely care for each other on a personal level. We push each other as students, we motivate each other, and we continuously develop into better versions of ourselves because of those around us. We also create space for important conversations to be had. For instance, in the fall, we had events for Culture Week and Black History Month. And in the summer, we saw the Indigenous Cultural Alliance collect shoes to raise awareness for the remains of Indigenous children found in Camp Loops. And I can't forget the Kick for the Cure and Chew for the Cure initiatives that take place amongst our varsity sports teams to raise money for cancer research. As a community, we acknowledge that it is our duty to create safe spaces on campus for all students, regardless of their backgrounds. On the other hand, we have an array of opportunities that just continuously come at us. For all the education students, how nice was it teaching kids in the classroom so soon into your degree? And although COVID put a halt on your practicum, Bishop still came through and found a way to ensure you had all the right elements to finish what you had started. We also pride ourselves in the hands-on experience that we have access to, which allows us to constantly enhance our skill set. For example, for us business students who participated in case comps, it may have been absolutely horrible having Rena, Sam, and Bill grill us week by week by week, but hey, now we know exactly what not to do. And education students, Dr. Stonebanks may have pushed you at times, but how fortunate are you now to not only be better teachers, but better people? And finally, the growth. Like the sign at the front of the school says, remember how you entered, be proud of how you leave. I personally remember entering as a scrawny 18-year-old, excited to meet new friends, but being so anxious about starting my path in the business program. I also remember crying for 3 weeks straight after my parents dropped me off because I was so homesick. And now I look back and I know my younger self would be so proud, not only because of what Bishops allowed me to accomplish, but because of the person it allowed me to become. And I want all of you in this virtual ceremony to acknowledge that same growth that occurred within yourselves. So at this point, you're probably expecting an uplifting message or a great quote to really make this an official valedictorian speech. But before I do that, I want to share some quick lessons that Bishops taught me. Number one, lead with intention. Good leaders are willing to get to the top, but also bring people up with them to show them how it's done. Be someone worth following. As we learn here at Bishops, there's power in numbers, and supporting other people with intention allows you to have a greater impact on those around you. Number two, learn to be an accidental apprentice in all aspects of life. I heard this point in a podcast a few months ago, and it really stuck with me. You need to be willing to constantly learn and be a never-ending student. Number three, chase genuine people and passions. As we leave this bubble, we may pursue the wrong jobs or the wrong things at times, but that's to be expected as young adults. But people and passions are what keep the fuel going in you. It's what will help you live a compelling future. Number four, discomfort is the price of admissions for a meaningful life. Accepting your offer to come to Bishops was probably extremely uncomfortable, and I'm sure you may have had friends or family like myself who wanted you to stay closer to home. But now, look at what you just completed here. And that would have never been possible had you not made the leap of faith. And finally, number five, the more you can divorce from outcome and focus on the process itself, the more you are in a position to succeed. The reason we're here celebrating today is because of the process we just went through to get to this point. It's those late nights with friends after a night at the Lion. It's staying at the library all hours of the night. It's even the annoying Lennoxville train that for some reason has to pass every 3 hours. It's the fashion shows, the gate nights, and every moment in between, from the point that you step foot on campus to the moment you leave. And now, it's time to acknowledge the reality of our situation. Once we graduate, life will be much different and a lot will change. If you think about it, from the moment we were 5 years old, we always knew what was next, from kindergarten all the way to university. But now, for the very first time, we don't have that secure next step. But the nice part, or the scary part, is that it's entirely up to us. And at the end of the day, while this next stage may seem a little uncertain, there's one thing I know for sure. What we learned here and the connections we made will remain with us forever. And with every new chapter, we'll look back and be so grateful to have chosen Bishops as our university. So as I wrap things up, I want to share one last point with you all today. And I take no offense if you don't remember any of my speech by tomorrow, but I do want to leave you with this. People in this life are going to do extraordinary things. So why can't that be us?
Chancellor Daniel Fournier, Chair of the Board of Governors, Robert Hall, Chair of the Bishops' Council, Yolan James, members of the Class of 2021, members of Convocation, families and friends. Every year, for 178 years, Bishops has celebrated this special day in the life of our university. But as the Chancellor said, this is only the second time that we have held a convocation remotely. My first words to the class of 2021 are that we missed having many of you on campus, and I know that you have missed each other. This is not the way you wanted to complete your time at Bishop's, and it was not the way that you ever imagined convocating. The challenge of responding to COVID-19 has been significant for Bishop's as an institution and for each of you. The campus was eerily quiet at times, but we are grateful to our faculty and staff that for most of the year, we were able to have a higher percentage of students on campus than most Canadian universities. So whether you spent your year here in Lennoxville or at home, I know it cannot have been easy attending some or all of your classes via screen from your bedroom or your kitchen table. And I want to express my admiration for the resiliency, self-discipline, and determination that you have demonstrated in this difficult and unprecedented time. One of the reasons we had a successful year academically is that 23 students served as online learning and technology consultants. They supported faculty members in preparing and delivering hybrid and online courses. Despite the stringent COVID-19 protocols, the SRC organized a great orientation week for incoming students. Over 100 student volunteers organized the events for the new students. A team of 28 students, called the Safe Gator Squad, helped everyone keep safe. With the generous support of alumni and friends of the university, the student services team created the Be United Peer Support Center to offer emotional and practical support for students. And with funds raised from alumni, faculty, and staff, Thanksgiving meals were provided to over 500 students. Wednesdays in the quad became an opportunity for safe outdoor gatherings, with hot chocolate served in the winter and lemonade once the weather got warmer. Our recruitment team loaned their purple cars to get students to and from the local vaccination center. And many events like the film festival and fine arts showcases were transformed into virtual events for all members of the Bishop's community. During Pride Month, we unveiled a Pride crosswalk on campus, which celebrates our LGBTQIA2+ community. Students' mental health was very much our focus this year, and your class contributed to developing initiatives to support your peers, like maintaining the pass-fail option for courses and creating a Fall Student Success Week, which will be introduced this fall. Students were also involved in establishing a new position of an Equity, Diversity, and Inclusion Advisor, and in the creation of a Sustainable Development Plan and a committee to examine responsible investment at the university. So it was a unique year, and I'm pleased to say that you rose to the challenge. The pandemic has affected all of us, but it will not define us. And we can all take pride in knowing that we met our two highest priorities, which have guided us since March 2020, to keep everyone safe and to support our students so that they could complete their academic programs. A lot has happened this year in the Bishop's community. And although we speak of the Bishop's bubble, we do not operate in isolation from the world beyond Lennoxville. In fact, we had students from 70 countries enrolled this year. I often say that the world meets on our campus. Well, today the reverse is true. There is hardly anyone on the campus today, but through this video, Bishop's is present in homes across Quebec, in the rest of Canada, and around the world. Like all great institutions, Bishop's has evolved over the decades, as each generation has been charged with ensuring that the university meets the needs of its time. We can all take pride in knowing that although much has changed, Bishop's continues to pursue its core mission of offering a sound and liberal education to its students. We remain focused on being an institution of choice for outstanding young people seeking academic excellence and a rich student experience. We strive to be a university that instills curiosity, confidence, courage, and a sense of responsibility in its students. To be a place that nurtures personal and intellectual freedom and fosters enduring friendships. We are proud that our graduating students consistently tell us that we have delivered on the promises we made to them when they chose Bishops. For the fifth time in 6 years, our students have ranked Bishops as first for student satisfaction amongst Canada's primarily undergraduate university in the Maclean's magazine rankings. On a pro rata basis, we also ranked first in faculty awards in a 5-year tally of the number of full-time professors who have won national awards. And we ranked in the top 2 in mental health services. So it seems that the years that you spent at Bishops were good for you and for the university. Now, much of Bishops has endured over time. Our heritage buildings, our bucolic campus, and most importantly, our focus on a liberal education. But it is also true that each generation of students reinvents the university. And the class of 2021 has contributed to Bishops being an intellectually vibrant, ambitious, and caring community. J'ai été vivement impressionné par les efforts de nos finissants afin que les valeurs fondatrices de notre université soit transmise à la prochaine génération d'étudiants qui, à leur tour, sauront les adapter et les transmettre. Ils ont démontré aux étudiants qui les suivent que les valeurs fondamentales que sont la curiosité, la rigueur, le respect d'autrui, l'intégrité et l'engagement sont des valeurs sûres et ce faisant, ils ont marqué de façon positive leur université. Et grâce à nos étudiants et toute notre communauté universitaire, je peux dire que Bishops a eu une année exceptionnelle. So I would like to take a few moments to review some of the many highlights of this past year. Each of us will have our own perspectives on what made this year special. During your time on campus, you saw the closing of Divinity House. The Bishops community participated in developing a plan to transform Divinity into Kwigwamna, which will include an Indigenous center and gathering space. You were able to enjoy the first stages of the renovation of the Student Center. And when you come back for a homecoming next year, you should bring your bathing suits to enjoy the renovated pool in our Sports Center. We're also building a new residence across from Dewhurst, which you will see when you come back to campus. And while I'm mentioning infrastructure changes, I want to congratulate our students for their efforts over several years to get the Quebec Ministry of Transport to install a stoplight at the corner of Reed and College so that our students can cross the road safely. The new stoplight has made crossing College Street much safer. Some of you have also participated in the planting of the first of 10,000 new trees that we will be adding to the campus this year. Individually and collectively, the class of 2021 consistently responded to the needs of people less fortunate than themselves. Whether it was the charity fashion show, which, although it could not be held in person, nonetheless raised funds for a local seniors' residence, or our student athletes fundraising and distributing bags of food for a local food bank, our students have consistently given their time, their energy, and their resources to help others. So we owe a great debt of gratitude to the class of 2021 for how you have cared for each other, for this institution, and for the world. There are several other highlights I would like to mention. Our Williams School of Business students finished on the podium in 15 virtual case competitions. And for the second year in a row, accounting graduates achieved a 100% pass rate on the Chartered Professional Accounting exam. The National Model United Nations was held virtually for the first time. The Bishops team representing Ireland received an Outstanding Delegation Award and 6 Outstanding Delegate and Position Paper Awards. Students in the Sustainable Agricultural and Farm Systems Club collected sap from the maples on the farm to produce Bishop's first batch of maple syrup. And your classmate Georges-Philippe Gadoury-Sanfasson was awarded a 3M National Student Fellowship. Across our 10 varsity sports teams, over 150 student athletes earned academic All-Canadian status, which is amongst the highest rates in the entire country. We welcome two outstanding speakers in the Donald Lecture Series this year. These were the first lectures delivered without an in-person audience. Marie Wilson, one of the three commissioners of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, shared her experience as a commissioner and provided wise advice about how we can make concrete progress together. And Dr. Jane Goodall, renowned environmentalist and humanitarian, joined us from her home in England. Over 2,000 students, staff, faculty, alumni, and community members registered for the talk by one of the most admired women of our time. For the first time in Bishop's history, 51% of our employees are women. This spring, Bishop's received a silver certification in the Women in Governance Parity Certification process, which evaluates parity at the decision-making level of organizations. Bishop's is one of the first universities in Canada to receive this recognition. There's not time to review all of the accomplishments of our diverse and multi-talented faculty, but it was certainly a year of innovation and achievement. Let me give you just a bit of the flavor of the academic vitality of our university. Dr. Jason Rowe, Canada Research Chair in Exoplanetary Astrophysics, is the leader of a team which has been granted a $1.1 million contract from the Canadian Space Agency. They will work on a project to develop the prototype of what could become Canada's next space telescope mission. Dr. John Runn, assistant professor in the Department of Physics and Astronomy, was appointed as a Tier 2 Canada Research Chair in Multi-Messenger Astrophysics, and we hope to announce three additional Canada Research Chairs later this year. Dr. Sarah Myriam Martin-Brulé of the Department of Politics and International Studies was selected as one of the 10 3M National Teaching Fellows in Canada. And you chose Dr. Heather Lawford of the Department of Psychology as this year's recipient of the William and Nancy Turner Teaching Award, which is given to a faculty member who has demonstrated exceptional educational leadership and commitment to students. We introduced new academic programs in musical theater, and in sustainable agricultural and food systems. And work has begun to develop our own educational farm. In fact, more than $1 million has already been pledged in philanthropic support for the educational farm. We were profoundly saddened by the sudden passing this summer of Dr. Sylvie Becquet. Dr. Becquet taught in the Williams School of Business for 38 years. And was a highly appreciated faculty member by her colleagues and by successive generations of Bishop students. It's reassuring to see that our students are engaged in the world because there is much to be concerned about. As a community, we were deeply disturbed to learn of the discovery of the unmarked graves of hundreds of Indigenous children on the grounds of former residential schools in Canada. These discoveries brought home to many of us the devastating effects that residential schools and systemic racism against Indigenous people have had and continue to have on Canada's Indigenous peoples and on our entire country. Last month was the hottest month ever on Earth. The temperature in Lytton, British Columbia reached 49.6 degrees centigrade. The highest temperature ever recorded in Canada. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change issued its most stark assessment of the climate crisis, the effects of which are being experienced around the world. The fall of the government in Afghanistan and the country's takeover by the Taliban will have devastating implications for women and girls in that country. Whether it is racism, discrimination, inequality, social injustice, or climate change, the challenges facing you are daunting. As intractable as some of these challenges or conflicts may appear, it is important that we remind ourselves that there is a vast gulf between doing nothing and doing something, no matter how modest its impact. So we are counting on the class of 2021 not to be passive bystanders, never to be silent or indifferent in the face of racism, discrimination, injustice, inequality, intimidation, or environmental degradation. As complex as these challenges are, we are confident that you are equipped to address them. I will conclude my remarks by saying how pleased I am to note that when you sang the school song several years ago in front of the principal's residence, you were wrong about never graduating. But I suspect you were right when you sang the line that college days will linger ever in your hearts. You will certainly linger in ours. And perhaps the words about never graduating were not meant to be taken literally. Perhaps never graduating means remaining loyal to your friends. Perhaps never graduating means never losing your sense of curiosity and your joy in learning. Perhaps never graduating means never ceasing to respect and value people who are different from you. Perhaps never graduating means never being afraid to take risks in pursuit of your dreams. Vous avez fait honneur à votre université, à vos familles et surtout à vous-même. C'est donc avec une grande fierté, mêlée d'un peu de tristesse, que nous vous disons au revoir. You have done your university, your families, and yourselves proud. It is with a bittersweet feeling that we bid you adieu. We do so, however, with confidence that you leave here ready and determined to choose your own paths, to further the boundaries of knowledge, to care for our planet, and to do your part in the never-ending quest to advance peace, justice, equality, and prosperity in the world. Nous suivrons vos réalisations avec grand intérêt. It will be exciting to watch you. Congratulations for all you have achieved, and thank you for all you have contributed. So celebrate today, and then go out and use the knowledge and skills you acquired at Bishop's to make the better world you believe in. Congratulations.
I now declare this first phase of the convocation ceremonies for Bishop's University's class of 2021 to be concluded. And I invite you to reconvene in person here on the Bishop's campus, next June 2022. Until then, I wish you all well. À la prochaine.
Cut to the core.